can't help but think that this doesn't add up. I'm trying to separate the facts from all the fiction. We're living in a world of contradictions, and if baby you're the truth, then I'm lying next to you.
This is Shea with BlackSheepHGX.com, sitting here with Daley here at Warehouse Live. Starting off, Daley, you've actually sold out both rooms tonight. You're actually in the bigger room. How does that feel?
It's great. It's good, yeah. It's obviously it's always an amazing feeling, and this tour has been kind of a really interesting one because we were touring just before I dropped the new music, so I was a little like, is this gonna work? And then it's just the kind of the way the time worked out, but it's been great. So yeah, it's been nice to be packing out the shows. Houston's always a good show.
Selling out everywhere, okay? You said new music, so when are when is that coming?
Well, I'm like debuting some little, testing some pieces out on tour, so it's been getting really good reactions. I've got a new single, which is going to drop hopefully in the next couple of weeks.
Okay.
And then, obviously, maybe a couple months, maybe 3 months later, we'll do full albums.
That's exciting. Yeah, I'm looking forward to that, actually. Any collaborations that can be on the album, any projects, or anybody working on it?
Yep. I'm not going to give it away yet, but yeah, I've got a couple of really, really amazing collaborations that I'm like really,
holding close to the chest.
Yeah, and but like quite honored to have these people involved. So so it's definitely some of that, and I'm just really enjoying. I've really enjoyed the process of like.
Okay, so describe your process. Like, what do you do? Do you just sit down with pen and paper and write about life, or what? Where do you get your inspiration from?
I pretty much, if I go into write a song, maybe I'll be working with a producer or something, I just, unless I already know what it is I want to write about, I pretty much just sit there and try and pinpoint what the most pressing thing is on my mind at that time, whatever that is, whether it's a love issue or a life thing or a political thing or whatever, and just try and turn it into a, song title and then just kind of build it from there. And then drift into a melody and then some lyrics to it.
Okay, you said politics as well. I've been watching the presidential debates.
Not really.
I mean,
it just kind of looks like a circus to me right now. So, and I'm not even, I hate politics to a degree. Like, I know it's necessary in some ways, but I just sometimes lose so much hope. The more I know about politics, the less hope I have
all the time.
Which is really, so yeah, and I mean this whole Trump thing, whatever, it's just like, it's kind of beyond a joke, so, but it's not a joke.
I got you. Okay, moving back to the music. Who were some of your musical influences? Like, who inspired you to become Daley?
Musical influences, I always cite my biggest influence being Prince.
Okay.
Prince is, just the one who really kind of made me understand, I feel like, artistry, and how to be an artist and have control of what you're doing and have an identity as an artist. It's not just music, it's not just like how you present yourself, it's like a whole thing,
The package, package.
And just to like really take care of everything you do and make sure that it reflects what you want to reflect. So Prince, and I mean, when I first started just getting into my own taste of music, it was always like vocals that drew me in at first, so. Prince, people like Sade, Shaka Khan, Maxwell, D'Angelo, Radiohead, like some stuff from some UK kind of vibes and Imogen Heap and stuff like that.
Yeah, okay, that's a good little mix right there. Yeah, you said Maxwell, like your Pretty Wings cover is amazing. Like all your covers are actually really, really good. How do you pick songs to cover? Like what, are you just listening on the radio like, oh, I like this song, let me cover it, or is there a process behind that?
It's never usually a song that's on the radio, but not many of my covers are like really radio songs, but top 40 anyway. But like with me, it's just like I'm still just such a music lover. Like even at my shows, I go in and do little snippets of covers in between songs and stuff because I just love it. Like I just have fun with it. So it usually just comes down to me. I'm constantly singing and stuff, just all the time when I'm not working. So if I really connect to a song or, then I'm always intrigued to see how it sounds recorded. And then, the ones that feel, the ones that make it usually that I'll release out are the ones that I feel like I've actually been able to connect to,
Okay, so it's all about that connection for
you. Yeah.
All right, so you've toured with a lot of different artists. who have you bonded with the most? Who has taught you the most while you've been on tour with them? Anybody or?
Yeah, that's an interesting one. Well, I mean, I learned a lot with the Gorillaz, but that was like my very first tour, so obviously I learned a lot. That was the first thing I did, so. And that was just a crazy tour because it was, they had so many featured artists on that tour. They had like, it was me, Little Dragon, Snoop, De La Soul, a few like UK artists, artists called Rosie to the Door, two British rappers, Bashi and Kano, and just like, it was like such a mad mix of people. So that was really cool. And Damon Albarn, who's the lead rapper, kind of, you know, guided me early on in those days, I think. And then more recently, I did some touring with Maxwell last year, which is really cool. And he's been amazing, you know, so supportive of my stuff and, you know, really championing what I'm doing. So he's, I'm trying to think, I don't know if he's given me like specific advice, but, you know, it's just inspiring just to see somebody.
Just watching him on stage with, you know, same thing you're basically on.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, okay. Can you describe your sound to us? I know you call it, is it futuristic soul, future soul?
Yeah.
Future throwback?
Used to like, yeah, some, we kind of coined like future throwback soul, but which it kind of is, but I'm trying not to say that now because it's starting to become like a tagline. But I think it's just like, ideally I would just say I'm a singer-songwriter.
Because
I kind of like, the whole genre thing gets so...
messy.
Yeah, and so, you know, defined and stuff. But I'd say probably like alternative, soulful singer-songwriter.
Because if you look at you, you're not like, oh, this guy sings R&B. You kind of you can see that you do like a whole bunch of different things. Like you said, Prince has been your influence, kind of a whole bunch of different things.
Yeah.
All at once.
It's just cool. I think it's just that my more R&B feeling songs, which you know, I do have quite a few, but they're the ones that have really kind of seemed to have lifted up. So, but it's cool because I mean, R&B is one of my, and soul is my absolute favorite. So.
Okay. And so you're from the UK.
Mm-hmm.
A lot of artists now are coming out of the UK. How has this, you know, British influence of artists like, you know, Adele and, you know, the late Amy Winehouse, things like that, how have they impacted you as an artist?
Amy, yeah, like, I don't know, I mean, I feel like she's the last, like, real artist who had that, you know, soul and, like, spirit of, like, a really old legend, do you know what I mean? I feel like I feel like, no, that's a legend. Like, she's the... I can't think of anyone recent, really, and that's no disrespect to anyone who's like, doing well at the moment. I just feel like Amy Winehouse had that legendary, like, when she's performing, you know, she's, like, in another place.
Yeah.
Like, her eyes are kind of glazed over, and she kind of had that. So, and I was really influenced. I should have mentioned that. She's one of my big influences as well, songwriting-wise. And, and, yeah, I'd say Amy, definitely.
Good. So we have new music coming out in April-ish.
Like in the next couple of months. But I mean, well, next couple of weeks for the new song, and then next couple of months for now.
Song and video, or just song, or
Video. Maybe like a month after we drop the song.
Okay. It'll have to be a Black Sheep exclusive then.
Okay.
All right. Okay. So what we like to do with every interview, we like to play like a little game, like a little lightning round, where I ask you know a question with two options, you answer it, first thing comes to your head.
I'm really bad at these.
So we'll see how you do. All right, first, Beyonce or Rihanna? First person.
Rihanna.
Okay, why?
I mean, they're both incredible. I think I just admire Rihanna's just a little more raw.
Okay.
I feel like it's a little more of her, like, personality.
Okay. M&M's or Skittles?
M&M's.
Why? Just the chocolate, like the flavor?
Yeah, I'm not really a fruity person.
Okay. In-N-Out or Whataburger?
I haven't had any of those things.
Really?
No.
We should have brought you some Whataburger.
No, but I don't. Well, I don't eat beef, so.
We can do that. Ham chicken.
Yeah. Okay. Maybe I would try it, but I'm like, that's the one thing with America. I mean, I love being here, but you guys really love fast food, like.
All right.
The enthusiasm for fast food here in burgers is like more than I can.
Yeah. I got you. So you're more of like a clean eater.
Yeah.
No, just straight plant-based or just
fish
and chicken in there as
well? Fish and chicken, yeah.
Okay. Yeah. Favorite city in Texas?
Favorite city in Texas? Houston.
All right.
Yeah, I've got family here, so, you know.
Okay, that works out. All right, this has been Daley with BlackSheepHTX.com. Signing off.
Hey, what's going on? This is Daley, and I'm here with Black Sheep.
Mm-hmm.